स्टूडेंट्स जय हिंद, गुड मॉर्निंग। वी आर ऑलरेडी कंटिन्यूइंग अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सेक्शन ऑफ योर साइंस, यू आर नोइंग दैट, अंडरस्टैंड। वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग ऑप्टिक्स। नाउ डियर स्टूडेंट, एज फार एज ऑप्टिक्स इज कंसर्न, इन लास्ट two lectures we have studied about reflection of light. Not only that, we have studied about reflection of light, some of the universally accepted law regarding reflection of light, and we also studied, and one important statement we studied, that reflection can take place from any surface. It can be plane, rough, or even spherical surface. We have studied about it formed by plane mirror. Then we targeted to study about the image formed by spherical mirror. We studied about concave mirror and convex mirror. We studied about some important terms regarding spherical or curved mirror, and we started studying various images formed by concave mirror. Okay, that topic we were targeting, if you can remember, in our last lecture too, 2.1.3, image formed by concave mirror. We are continuing the same topic today, but before that, today lecture number 3, and in lecture number 3, your chapter number 10, as we all know, light, reflection and refraction. Okay, we are concentrating on the topic of reflection of light. Okay, in that we were studying about images formed by concave mirror. One image we have already studied, where the object was kept at infinity, if you can remember, understand, in last lecture, where we have studied, understand, that the object was kept at infinite distance, at infinity. At that time I suggested you that when you are speaking of infinity, doesn't mean really infinity. Really thinking infinity in terms of mirror is like some reasonable distance from radius of curvature. Okay, so first we have studied where the position of object was. It was at infinity, where the image was obtained exactly on principal focus. What is the nature and size of the image we studied? Real, inverted and diminished. I told you at that time, before we start today's topic, that whenever you prepare any ray diagram, always you start thinking and just revolving your mind around these three facts: position of object, position of image, nature and size of image. You just twist your, or you just throw your brain, imagination, or your thinking between these three facts. You start imagining this way: position of object, position of image, nature and size of image. You think of position of object, your mind has to be immediately respond to position of image and nature and size. You think of position of image, your mind has to respond on position of object and nature of image. You think of primarily nature of image, your mind has to respond quickly for position of object and position of image. That way, okay, dear student. So topic 2.1.3 continues in today's lecture. That is, what is the topic? You all know, images formed by concave mirror. That's the topic which we are targeting today. Understand? And as we have already studied one particular diagram, now we are going to target other diagrams. Okay? Image formed by concave mirror. Let us take diagram number 2. Already given in your material also. Here you just have to think, understand how to do it, and you have to draw with me position of object, right? Position of object. Now we are first, initially we have kept the object at infinity. Now we are bringing the object, understand, nearer to center of curvature. That is what we are doing now. Okay, so I can write this way also, further from center of curvature. You can symbolize it as C, further from C, that center of curvature, sometime away from center of curvature. Means you must imagine this way, that we are trying to bring the object nearer and nearer to the mirror. First we kept it at infinity and we got a point like diminished image. Now we are shifting the object, understand, and object is from infinity brought little near to the mirror, means away from center of curvature. Let us try to make the image of this. Okay, away from center of curvature. First, what you have to do, you have to draw a lens, or sorry, you have to draw a concave mirror every time. These are some compulsory things you need to do. Now this is pole. Okay, and then you all know an imaginary line passing through pole and center of curvature. Here I can show focus and here I can show C, that center of curvature. Object is to be placed away from center of curvature, means we are bringing nearer to the mirror. You understood, dear student? So now the object is here. Suppose this is object AB. We are bringing the object nearer to the mirror. First ray, dear student, understand, passing from or parallel to the principal axis. And after reflection, what is going to happen? That I am showing this way, okay? Parallel to principal axis, and after reflection will pass through the principal focus. I am showing the reflected ray by different color so that it will strike in your mind immediately. Okay, first ray has already been done, that is ray parallel to the principal axis, and after reflection from mirror passes through center of curvature. Okay, now dear student, if you want to target the second ray, you can take that ray also, passing from focus and becoming parallel, or you can directly pass a ray from center of curvature which will reflect in the same direction. You all know very well, this ray which was actually passing from center of curvature will reflect in the same direction. Two reflected ray, dear student, one is parallel and passing through focus, and one is passing through focus and will reflect in the same direction. Both the rays are actually converging here. So this, how to draw the image now? This is the intersection point of both the reflected ray. Now you have to understand, extend this, and this is your image. Image is inverted, dear student. You have to put arrow this way. To name the image, I will call top as A dash, bottom as B dash. This is the image we got. Understood? Image is obtained below principal axis and it is already inverted image. Okay? So, dear student, it has been given in material, no doubt, but you should also do it with me so that you can understand how to draw the diagram. Now, where the image is obtained between C and F, okay? So, if I write the position of image, suppose I write position of image, where I got the image? Between principal focus and center of curvature. To write in short, I can write this way, between C, that center of curvature, and F, that is focus. Then what is the nature and size of image? So you can read from the diagram itself, dear student. Okay, this was the object and this is the way the image is formed. Whenever you get inverted image, real always, because real image are always inverted image, and it is looking from the diagram itself, it precisely done that object is larger, image is smaller. So as far as nature and size of image are concerned, what you can write? Real, inverted, and smaller. What you can write? Real, inverted, and smaller. Okay, dear student, try to understand this diagram. Where the position of object was, that was further from center of curvature. Where the image got position between C and F, what is the nature and size of the image? Real, inverted, and smaller. Before we move to another diagram, as I told you, your mindset has to understand, you have to just throw your thinking around the three corners, okay? Position of object, position of image, nature and size of image. You think nature and size of image, real, inverted, smaller. The next two fact has to click your mind away from center of curvature between F and C. Image is obtained between F and C. Rest of the two fact has to struck your mind away from center of curvature, real, inverted, and smaller. This way you remember, this way you need to prepare, and then any MCQ regarding this asked to you, you will be able to answer them quickly, precisely, and accurately. But for that you have to train your mind to answer the fact this way. Understood? So this is second diagram, dear student, where position of object was further from center of curvature, image obtained between C and F, and name, nature and size of image, real, inverted, and smaller. First, I am just giving you a little time to think about this, and then we try to go for the next diagram, okay? First, you just verify this, and also at the same time, note down one very important fact. when the object was at infinity, the image was point-like diminished. Now, when the object is brought nearer to the mirror, the image grew little bigger. It, no doubt, it is smaller than the object, but it is bigger than the point size. So, as you bring object nearer and nearer to the mirror, the size of the image increases. Remember this one line, dear student. I can ask in exam, if object is brought nearer and nearer to the mirror, what happens to the image? The image grew bigger and bigger. Remember this as a one line also. It can be asked in MCQ rather than one true option. Rest of the three options I give wrong, but your mind has to be very clear. Object brought nearer, image becomes bigger and bigger. Okay. Now, let us go for the third one. Third image we are going to study now. Okay. Third image now. Let us write the options here only. First, third one now. Okay, I am not writing number that way, but we are writing position of object. Position of object. So every time we do not have to write it, okay? Then position of image. Position of object, position of image, and then third, nature and size of image. Okay, every time this is going to be common for us. Two diagrams we have already studied. Initially, object was at infinite, then object was further than center of curvature, and then now we are imagining the third diagram, third image formed by concave mirror. Okay, first two over, infinity, then brought nearer means little away from center of curvature. Now we are keeping the object, still we are bringing the object nearer. So, I am resting the object on center of curvature. So, I would write in short, at C. You can understand it. When I am speaking at C, you can understand that the object is rested or object is positioned at center of curvature. Okay, object has been positioned at center of curvature. Now, let us think about the diagram, how to draw it. First, dear student, as you all know, concave mirror, image needs to be drawn sharp, okay? This is the opaque surface. Now, this is pole, okay? Then, principal axis, as you know. Then F, and exactly at this distance, center of curvature. The object is to be positioned at center of curvature. Here I am showing the object AB, rested at center of curvature. We are trying to understand the image formed, the first ray, as you know, parallel to the principal axis. And after reflection, it will pass through principal focus. Okay, this is the first ray, parallel to principal axis and passing through center of curvature. Now here, dear student, we can't utilize that second ray. If you can remember the last diagram, where the second ray we have taken passing from center of curvature and reflecting back in the same direction. We can't utilize that ray here. Why? Because object is already positioned on center of curvature, so we will utilize the ray contradictory to this. Parallel, passing from center of curvature, let us do it now. Passing from focus, I have done this ray, understand? Passing from focus and then becoming parallel, dear student. Okay, try to understand this. This ray I am extending. Passing from center of curvature and now it is becoming parallel. Okay. So image is obtained here at center of curvature. Okay. You draw it precisely, you will get exactly at this, okay? You have to draw the image precisely, so you will get it here, understand this way. This is reflected ray, okay? Both the rays are meeting here, and here they form the image, okay? Right, be little more conscious regarding this. The image is obtained exactly at center of curvature when both the rays are meeting. Understand? You take exact measurement, this one double than this, and you draw precisely the straight line. There will be no problem whatsoever in getting the image exactly here, A dash, B dash. Okay? So when the object was kept at C, at center of curvature, image is also obtained at center of curvature. So should I write, either I can write at center of curvature or I can write at C. Okay? If you observe the diagram precisely, this is object. And this is the image, okay? Even just by visualizing the diagram, height of the object and height of the image looking similar, so you can say in nature and size of the image what you can write real. Obviously, real means the another word attached with this, inverted, and real, inverted, and of same size, okay? Real, inverted, and of same size. So this is the third diagram you have to study, okay? Remember this diagram. First one, the object was positioned at infinite. The second one, object was farther than center of curvature. Now the object is rested at center of curvature, and nature and size of the image. Object was positioned at center of curvature. We got image also at center of curvature. Nature and size of the image, real, inverted, and of same size. Before we move to next diagram, a quick response to the all three facts. Position of object at C, rest of the two, you just think and speak. Position of image at C, nature and size, real, inverted, and of same size. Second one. Position of image at C, think of the rest too. Position of object at C, nature and size, real, inverted, and of same size. Third, nature and size, real, inverted, and of the same size, think of the rest of the two. Position of object at C, position of image at C. I think in objective section, if I can remember, in objective section, one of the question, See, dear student, you already have a physical copy of the material. If you come to the objective section, verify MCQ number 12. What is written there? MCQ number 12. Where should be the object be placed to obtain real and diminished image using a concave mirror? There are options given to you. Understand, dear student? What are they? Between principal focus and pole, at center of curvature, between principal focus and center of curvature, beyond center. Beyond center of curvature means at infinity. Understand? So when you are thinking beyond center of curvature, that means infinity. So MCQ, if you have studied the ray diagram, understand perfectly. Not only you have just drawn the diagram, but while drawing the diagram, if you have been an accurate enough to just coin or toss your brain between these three facts, position of object, position of image, nature of the image, it becomes very easy for you to answer such questions. Okay? Is it clear in your mind? Position of object at C, position of image at C, nature and size of image, real, inverted, and of same size. Okay, dear student. Next, let us take. As you all are just now studying that by plane mirror, only one type of image was possible, but it is not the case with the spherical mirror. In case of spherical mirror, if you change the position of the object, position of image also changes at the same time. Nature and size of the image also go on varying. Okay? Now, position of object. What was that? First, infinity. Then, further than center of curvature. Then, at center of curvature. What you are doing? You are bringing the object nearer and nearer to the mirror. Now, let us write the next. Between. Object is to be positioned between F and C. That means, now we are shifting the object. Understood? Let me take, between F and C, that means the object is positioned between principal focus and center of curvature. Okay, let us try to understand the image formation, nature and size of image. This is concave mirror, dear student. Okay. Concave mirror, opaque surface, pole of the mirror, then principal axis, okay, then here focus, here center of curvature, let me extend the principal axis to facilitate the image. Now, dear student, object is kept between principal focus and center of curvature. AB is the object. Position between principal focus and center of curvature. The first ray parallel to principal axis and after reflection it will pass through focus. The first ray, it will pass through focus. This is the first reflected ray. Now second ray, dear, understand. If you can see in material, The first ray, they have utilized this. Now the second ray, dear student, can be any. Understood? Suppose this is center of curvature. You utilize this ray if you feel comfortable, or dear student, you utilize this ray also. Both the rays are allowed, either by C without reflection or by F also. I am targeting F. So suppose draw another ray passing through F. Understand? And after passing through F and striking on the mirror, understood, the center of curvature was at original, becoming parallel. Okay. Now both the rays are meeting here. The center of curvature was positioned here only, so I am keeping it here. So dear student, both the reflected ray in material, we have utilized this ray, understand, passing from C, striking and coming, but it becomes little difficult because you have to extend the aperture of the mirror if not sufficient. Okay, so I am neglecting that ray, rather I am targeting the ray passing from focus and then becoming parallel, and image is obtained here. This is the image. Where the image is obtained, dear student? Away from C, I can write away or farther from C, whatever word is suitable for you. Away from center of curvature, just by looking at the diagram, the things are becoming very, very clear in our mind. This was the object and this is the image. So we can write nature and size of the image. What is that? Real, inverted and larger, which you can see from diagram itself, that the object was smaller but the image is larger. So the type of the nature and size of the image is real, inverted and larger, which you can see even from the diagram itself. The moment you complete the diagram, just start tossing your brain between the three facts. Nature and size, if I speak, real, inverted, larger, position of image away from C, position of object between F and C. Second, position of image between F and C, toss your brain between the rest of the two facts. Position of object between F and C, nature and size, real, inverted and larger. Okay, start tossing your brain between these three facts. It will help you to solve MCQ. Okay, so this is clear in your mind. Now dear student, first just have a look before I move to the next diagram. Okay, just go on remembering the images, dear student. First, real inverted point sized, then real inverted smaller, grew bigger and bigger, then real inverted end of same size, then real inverted and larger, means as the object is brought nearer and nearer to the mirror, the image start growing bigger and bigger. Okay, let us take the next one. Now we are going to target, means we will keep the object at focus. Okay, so this is next diagram. Position of object at F, means at focus. Let us try to study it. Understand, we are keeping the object at focus. This is concave mirror. Okay, these are opaque surfaces. Here is the pole of the mirror, then principal axis. Here is F, that is focus, and here center of curvature. Now dear student, if you can verify in our material, understand, position number 5, Diagram number 5, position of object at principal focus means at F, and let us try to realize the image formed when we are keeping the object at focus. Which type of image will be formed when the object is rested at focus? Let us see that. Object is here, dear student. Suppose I saw object this way. You may start questioning in your mind that why sir has shown a smaller object, because if I saw larger one, then for this ray passing from center of curvature and reflecting back, it becomes little difficult for you. You have to extend the curvature. That's why I have shown intentionally the smaller object. Chalo, first ray, you all know, parallel, and then where it is going to pass, obviously this ray will be, after striking the mirror, passing from center or passing from focus. First you draw this ray, dear student. I am waiting for you. First you have to show this ray parallel to principal axis and then passing through focus. Okay, now for the second ray, we can draw this way. The ray, dear student, was passing through center of curvature. Okay, this way you have to show, striking the mirror and reflecting back in the same direction. Okay, I am showing first going this way, now reflecting back in the same direction. Now, dear student, what you can understand, initially if I saw this arrow, you can mark the ray was traveling this way and the blue arrow is showing that the ray reflected and passing back to the center of curvature, and these two ray travel to infinity. Understand, dear student? And they form an image. So where the image will be getting formed? At infinity, at infinite distance. You can write this way, at infinity. Okay, what is the nature and size of the image, dear student? Exactly contradictory to the first image, where the object was positioned at infinity and image was obtained real, inverted and smaller, diminished, you know. Exactly contradictory to that, image will be real, inverted and highly enlarged. Okay, dear student, highly enlarged image, right? Real, inverted and highly enlarged. This is where the object was kept at principal focus, and this is the way we get the image. Okay, just study this properly so that you can understand, and immediately start tossing your brain between the three facts: object, position at F, image at infinite, real, inverted, highly enlarged. Image, real, inverted, highly enlarged. Object at infinity, position of image at infinity. Position of image at infinity, object is positioned at principal focus and nature, real, inverted and highly enlarged. You understood this, dear student? So far, all these five ray diagram are giving us an idea. Understand, and in all five diagram, you have marked and noticed one thing, that we all are getting real images, real inverted images. In first case, real inverted diminished. Second, real inverted smaller, third real inverted same size, fourth real inverted larger, fifth real inverted highly magnified, means highly enlarged, but all are real images. Understand? So now only one position is left, that is we have to shift the object between focus and pole. That's the only image left for discussion. Okay, let us do that. Position of image. Image is to be positioned between focus and pole. Okay, I'm writing it here. Position of object between F and P. That means the object is positioned between focus and pole of the mirror. Okay, let us try to understand and realize which type of image become possible when we keep the object between F and P. Sometime I am speaking again and again the same thing. That is to enhance and that is to strengthen in your mind that the same process you have to do with your brain. That object is positioned between F and P. That means you have to speak like in your mind, like between principal focus and pole. Understand? Let us try to get the image. This is concave mirror. Okay, this is concave mirror. The opaque part as usual. Right, this is the opaque part we are showing, the painted back. This is pole of the mirror. And then, dear student, the principal axis. Here F I must show. Here center of curvature I have to show. Now, dear student, the object is kept here. This is the object I am showing here. This is object AB, position between principal focus and pole. Okay, the first ray you all know, parallel to principal axis, and after reflection passes through focus. Draw with me the first ray, dear student, parallel and then passing through focus. You draw just first ray with me. Okay? Right? Now the second ray, dear student, passing from center of curvature, reflecting back, you all know very well. Suppose I saw this way, understand, and then it will reflect in the same direction. Right? Sorry, here the arrow has to be this way, because black we are utilizing for the incident ray, and this is reflected ray. Are you watching that both the rays are meeting anywhere? Not at all. Both reflected ray are not meeting at all. If you want them to meet, then you extend principal axis behind the mirror and extend both the rays in its original direction, dear student. The first ray has been extended in its original direction. Then the second ray extended in its original direction. Okay, both the rays are meeting exactly behind the mirror. Okay, and this is the real image of the object. This is image obtained. Okay, AB is the image. A dash B dash. Where you got the image, dear student? Behind the mirror we got the image. So your first statement will be position of image behind the mirror. It is obtained behind the mirror. Can you see the variation and distinction in the image? This one and the last four, five image, yes. All images in the last five diagram you were getting below the principal axis. Understand? Here you got the image above the principal axis and you can see it is an erect image. Though the word real inverted needs to be contradicted now. You can write this way. Instead of real, you write virtual, opposite word. Instead of real, you write erect. Virtual, erect, and you can see magnified image. Virtual, erect, and magnified image we have obtained. Okay, just you verify, dear student. Some occasionally it can happen that some other ray has been used in a diagram in our material, but you can concentrate on this also. This also image can be possibly obtained. Okay, virtual, erect, and magnified image. Okay, verify this. How it is very important to draw the position of the ray first, parallel, passing from focus, second, passing from center of curvature, reflecting in the same direction. Both the rays are not meeting here at all, but if they are extended back behind the mirror, they are forming the image there. So this is already understood. An image formation which is virtual, erect, and magnified image. Okay, dear student? Just verify it. So, one thing must be clear in your mind. What we have done in today's lecture? We have studied various types of image formed by concave mirror. Okay, dear student, remember one thing very clearly, that in WRT, understand, I am going to ask at least out of the 20 MCQ, 11 to 12 MCQ, I will ask from the ray diagram fact. I am going to twist the fact and I am going to ask you, so that way you should prepare it properly, okay? And every time you draw the diagram, just toss your brain between the three facts: position of object, position of image, nature and size of the image. You just revolve your brain. Remember one, try to think of the rest two. Remember one, try to think of the rest two. Will help you in solving MCQ quickly. Okay, dear student? So for today's lecture, your homework is this, dear student. If you can verify at the back, understand the question number 3. With the help of ray diagram, state position and nature of the image for the following position of an object for concave mirror. I haven't mentioned, dear student, position of object, but you know we have already practiced all diagram. Understand? From initially infinity, then further than center of curvature, at center of curvature, between C and F, at F, between F and P, all six diagram you have to draw, write nature and size exactly in detail. Okay, so dear student, prepare all ray diagram properly. Okay, thank you very much.